What's the strangest date you've ever been on? Matched on Tinder with a guy who decided that a great story to tell in detail on our date was about the time he fisted a lady and tore her up so bad inside that she was bleeding profusely and had to go to the hospital to get stitches. After he was done telling the story, he told me he was glad I told him I was super squeamish because now he wouldn't try to show me pictures of all the blood he had saved on his phone. He also said he had been on well over 100 Tinder dates, and I had managed to land in his top 10. I never talked to him again. Had a good friend in uni who disappeared overseas for a year after we graduated. I stayed there to study and teach, and one day I got a text from a number one didn't recognize saying, "Hey, it's Joe from business school, want to catch up for a coffee?" Hadn't seen him in ages, so I said yes very enthusiastically. I walked into the coffee shop at the right time, look around for Joe, and there's Joe from business school. A different Joe from business school. I couldn't walk out, because he'd already seen me, so we chatted politely for an hour and we've never talked since. It's 2001, so VHS and chill at this girl's dorm room. My first time over there, and there is this giant bear on the bed. Like, got the softball in the milk jug at the carnival first try tier bear. It occupies 50% of the surface area. I say, "Whoa, how'd you score that bear?" "Huh, I don't know." "Me, what?" "Huh, I don't know." A few minutes go by. "Me, you don't know?" "Huh, yeah." "Me, okay, look. It's okay if it's from an ex. I don't care if you stole it. I'll believe almost anything you tell me at this point. But there is no way in hell you're going to tell me you don't know where that giant bear is from. I had a stuffed dinosaur one quarter that size that I got when I was 6, and I could tell you every detail about how I got it." "Well, good for you. But I don't know how I got it. Are you going to be able to let this go?" "Me, looks at bear. Bear stares back, eyes full of secrets. I don't think I can walk out." Hot girl from class randomly walked into my dorm room. The door was normally open during the day. She was in the building visiting a friend, and saw me playing guitar, so she came in and started flirting. She asked me to meet her at a nearby bar that night at 10, so I agreed. I get there at 10, and she introduces me to her boyfriend. I finished my beer, and went to the bar my friends were at. I was a waitress, and I had a table of two guys. One was very cute, and flirting with me, and we exchanged numbers. He asked me out, and I said yes. I didn't really go out much, and he didn't tell me where we were going out, what we were doing. Me being young and dumb at the time thought that would be exciting. So he drives me a pretty good way from my house and we go to an elementary school. I was really confused. Apparently he was a basketball coach, and they had a game that night. So at this point I notice I have no reception on my phone and I really wanted to leave, but I thought maybe we were going somewhere fun afterward. So I gave up trying to call someone to rescue me. I sat and watched this game right next to this dude's mom. Yeah, this was going well. Finally the game ended, and we go to get in the car and his friend from the restaurant gets in the front seat making me sit in the back. I'm super uncomfortable with this, and I ask what's going on. They basically tell me they want to run a train on me. Nope. F that. Take me home now. I got lucky. They mope and took me home. I was terrified. That was horrible. Maybe a bit more creepy than strange, but I haven't been on many dates. We met on Tinder, hadn't talked for too long, but I thought, what the hell, I need to get out more, blah blah. The first thing he said was, "Oh wow, you're so pretty," and tried to kiss me on the mouth. I sort of dodged and gave him a cheek and ignored it to avoid him getting embarrassed. He was not embarrassed. Two drinks in, we are talking a bit awkwardly, and he's clearly buying me double G&Ts instead of the singles I'm asking for. I was a bartender at the time. I can taste the difference. When I'm mid-sentence, he garbs my face and says, "Sorry, I just need to get this out of the way," and forcefully sticks his tongue down my throat. I didn't really know what to do, because I didn't want to cause a scene and he's about a foot taller than me. I said I needed to look up the time for the last train. He said, "No, it's fine, you can stay at mine." I said thanks, but I'll look up the last train. He begs, saying he'll sleep on the couch. He just wants to get to know me better. Still said no. He huffs, very briefly, and then cheers up, and tells me he'll look up the train time for me like a gentleman. He says it's at 1 a.m. I said that's late, is he sure? He gets all tense and says what? Don't you believe me? So I smiled, and said of course not, and then a few minutes later I excused myself to the toilet, and checked the times on my phone, which said the last train was actually at 12:15 a.m. Lovely. I went back to my seat, he asked if I wanted to wait at his flat for the last train, and I said no, I'm getting an Uber now, bye. He tried to beg me to stay, loudly and embarrassingly, so others could hear. Hopefully I'd get so embarrassed I'd go home with him, I guess, and even pretended it was his birthday, and yelled to the bar that he was protecting me by taking me home, because taxi drivers can be rabbits. I told him quietly to F off, and that I was going home, and he loudly asked for a hug, and tried to grab my bobs. Well, this one time I took my date to dinner at a front for some type of illicit activity. We had just moved to a new area, and we wanted to check out the local shops and restaurants. While we were wandering, we stumbled into a tiny Italian place. Back home, the small hole in the wall restaurants always have the best food, so we were excited to give it a shot. Big curtains were covering the entry windows, so we had no idea what was inside, until we trudged through the door. Inside, we were met with emptiness and silence. We both immediately thought the store was closed, and I spun around, and searched for the store hours posted somewhere on the door. While I was looking, we heard a heavy thud as a young woman barked, "I'll be right with you." She appeared, greeted us confusingly, and asked us what she could do for us. Which, looking back, is probably a red flag. But we were naive and hungry, so we said we were there for dinner. She looked puzzled, but motioned us to follow her to a booth right by the entrance. She then disappeared into the back, and we heard a muffled conversation between our hostess and a man. The consensus was basically they were not prepared for us, or didn't know how to proceed. I asked my date if she wanted to split, but she insisted we stay for the story. The square-shaped balding man burst through the kitchen door with two glasses of water for us, and in a very loud and deep voice he explained that it was his birthday, and we would eat what he felt like making us. We wholeheartedly agreed. We waited around 30 minutes, and he again returned with three large bowls of spaghetti and meat sauce. He placed two bowls in front of us, and one next to me for himself. He sat with us and ate. We had light and awkward conversation with him during, and he kept asking us jokingly if we were cops or with the health board. He was incredibly nervous about us, so my date kept cracking corny puns or awful jokes because he would forcibly laugh at anything designed with humor. We talked about our lives, the cities we've lived in, our pets. He had a teacup chihuahua named Princess, and his wife. He decided we were good people and didn't change us for the meal. We wished him a happy birthday, he hugged us, and we went on our way. Easily the best spaghetti I've ever had in my life. The restaurant, unfortunately, no longer exists. Met a girl online, talked it up, and while she seemed a bit immature, thought heck, why not? She casually mentioned she really liked pigs. What she meant to say was she was obsessed with pigs. Obsessed. Go to one of the best restaurants in the area for a first date. Bad idea. Sometimes pictures are from someone 10 years prior, or the person hides things, etc. But that wasn't the problem. She looked just like her pictures. But I didn't even have to have seen her first, because everything else gave it away. She came in a giant t-shirt that had a sparkly pink pig on it. Earrings. Pig earrings. Bracelets? Yep, pig bracelets. I swear her dad might have been Homer Simpson. She had this headband on with a little pig on it. Her shoes? Yep, pigs on the front of the toes. But best of all, she had a giant, or at least it seemed giant, pink purse with the face of a pig on it. You could not stop seeing it once you did. And I'm sure everyone else in this nicer/classier restaurant saw it too. I felt overdressed with her, but underdressed with every other couple there. It was beyond embarrassing. For some reason which I have to convince myself was politeness not stupidity, we still had dinner. But Reddit, it was the fastest damn dinner I've ever had at a sit-down place. I practically blurted out something about how, oh, you really do like pigs. Which she started giggling, oinking, and going on about how everything she has is pig themed. Then she wouldn't stop, and it became the dominant part of the conversation. There were a dozen other things that made it a train wreck, but these were the clinchers to a solid 0/5 date. I remember afterwards consoling with a friend of a friend, because I had to tell someone, and then I promptly buried this as my worst date. Girl was obsessed with pigs, but ironically no porking at end.